Everybody, welcome to a new video. So today I thought that it would be funny or fun to take a look at the World of Warcraft Cataclysm art book, as I did with the Burning Crusade art book as well. So that's what we're gonna do. I have a different angle, view angle than normally, and I would appreciate, you know, any feedback on this angle. What you guys think? Okay, so the first picture is Deathwing. And I believe this picture is from when he rises from the deep. If you don't know what I'm talking about, I suggest you to take a look at the trailer, the cinematic. I'm going to give you guys some time to look at the pictures. If there's something you would like to read, you can just pause the video and read it. I really like art books. It really shows the effort that the designers have been putting into the game. Now we have definitely again a few different pictures here. This picture is very unique because it shows Deathwing in his human form. He's a huge dragon. I'm pretty sure he's the biggest of them all. Here he is, and I'm very sure that this picture is supposed to be when he attacked Stormwind City. I'm not sure though, but that would be my guess. The login scream. Back in the days where Deathwing is standing there and just looking at you. Actually, this picture kinda reminds of it. That's the moment I'm talking about. And we have here the Cataclysm logo. All the different runes out here. Deathwing being pretty mad. He's very angry. He explains that and uses a word called rage. So here we have the Twilight, which is like a cult that supports Deathwing. They help him. And here are some of the structures. Here, example. You walk in here and you go across here and to get to the top here. Here. Like a dragon. Remind you that Deathwing was against everybody. He was also against do you have the dragon clans? I don't remember. I don't recall the name of them, but aspect of something. I can't remember everything. We have here a raid. This is the entrance for raid. And again, I don't recall. It's a very evil cult. As you can see on the way they live, there's nothing really, nothing good in them, it seems. Here we can see, this is a Twilight Hammer priestess. So this is what you're up against. Sure. Something called the Twilight Fortress. Both of these. We have a cultist. Looks like he has been enslaved? He doesn't look like a guy that has his own will. He just do whatever the point kind of tells them to do, I guess. I may be wrong. So I read the Wild Hammer. So, the Warhammer clan, I'm not an expert in lore, but I'm very sure that they got kicked out of Stoneforge City, and they got into wetlands, and they actually made their own city, which is this one, Grohl, something like that. And it got invaded by trogs and all kind of different stuff, and they lost it. Thousand needles here. But yeah, show here the needles. How it supposed to look, how it looked after Defwin came out of his hide. We have here Stormwind, the different kind of, I don't know what they're called, but in Danish it's called the States. Don't to rush. Had a duel with him. They were arguing about something. I don't recall what it was, but Garrosh wounded him. He didn't die. But the Grim Totems clan, which has been expelled from Thunderbluff, managed to poison him. And he died of that. And his son Bane took over. And as you can see here, it's a 1,000 needles. And it was flooded. It was very dry. And the ocean just came in. And it looked like this after. Totally flooded. So here we have the new war chief, Garrosh, the old war chief Thrall, and Garrosh after he had been chosen to be the new war chief. This is one of the backgrounds, and a wonderful craft. So this looks like in Ashara, that made the entire landscape, gave it a makeover, and the city came out in the middle of the sea. As you can see, this is Booty Bay. It was also getting flooded, but it kind of survived, which is a little bit weird. You have the barrens here, the crossroads. As you can see how it's supposed to look and how it normally started and after. Discipline that the whole takes. Lock the doors. Gilneas, which is the capital city of the Walkins. The artwork in Gilneas is very beautiful. I like it a lot. It's sad that they never really managed to do more with it. You see some of the buildings, a mill over here. It's a very beautiful landscape. Just huge. The physique of these guys are just insane. Now, some of the guys that were Walkins actually were able to transform themselves in the beginning. So, managed to, by the help of the Night Elves, managed to endure the torment and were able to control themselves. actually kind of looked like Sylvanas at first glimpse, but it wasn't. You see, the style of this is very medieval, kind of looks like a castle, and these buildings is incredible detailed in the game. Here we have the graveyard. In the storyline, this is a main, there's happening a lot of stuff here in the story. So that's a beautiful picture. So we have the three goblins. I would guess it's a two warriors and a mage against a rogue. And this is Gomez. We have the gate over here. That's been attacked by the undeads. We have the big city here. We have the forest here, where the walk-ins are hiding. I never really liked the goblin zone, to be honest. Only the second zone. First one, I hated it. This place, but beautiful as well. And look at that logo, that's very impressive. I've never seen it. So after you get evacuated from your start zone as a goblin, these little creatures are very evil. Very evil. This is the capital city of the gnomes that get destroyed. It's also a very dark place, which is one of the reasons why I don't like it. We have the goblin gang over here. Ghastly or something. He doesn't care about his people, he only cares about money. He don't give a fuck about goblins. He's right there. That's how he becomes. He transforms a little guy into a big guy. So here we see, he kind of looks a little bit scared, like, oh fuck, so I'm walking over here. Oh, this zone, this zone was a pain to get through, but again, a very beautiful zone, you really had something special that nothing else had, but God, it was a pain in the beginning. But you could use hours upon hours exploring this zone, and the story was also pretty nice. I'm pretty sure that this tomato thing was an entrance to a dungeon. I'm not sure though, but it kind of reminds me of that. I may be wrong. of sea creatures. This guy could take over if it could come upon your head. It could, like, control your mind. There's a boss fight in the dungeon I was talking about where he does that. Something going on there. Although was cold. Very cold, so as well. Like some cool stories as well. They actually had some pretty decent stories in this game. Zone. We're on the ferry. I love these pictures. They are so dark, but at the same time very bright. It really shows a magic place. Could you imagine standing there? The castle in the sky. This is a dungeon and a raid at the same time. Outside the ghost of Ultum. Again, I don't recall these dungeons. I remember that you could get a mount up here. This has to be the maelstrom. It has to be that. I didn't like that snow. But you could farm a lot of stuff there, which were pretty cool. Firelands raid where you could fight against Ragnaros again. Here we have some tire sets. So we have the mage here. I believe this is the warlock. This is the Death Knight. I guess it's the Death Knight. No, it's not. It's the Warrior. The Warrior set. Some pretty decent weapons. So yeah, that was the art book. Let me know what you think down in the comment section. If this was something that you would like to see me do more often.